Today we're going to take the drum sound from this to this. Hi, I hope you're all well and welcome back. Or if you're new, thanks for checking out the channel. I'm Matt from Distant Sun Studios, and today is the fifth part in the video series called Inside the Mix. We're going to cover a lot of ground over the next few episodes, so that you know what to expect. We'll be looking at summing together the individual drum microphones, using filters to avoid masking, bus processing, EQ and the fundamental frequencies, compression directly on a track and in parallel, and finally creating a virtual space for the drums. As ever, there are chapters throughout the video, so if you're short on time or just looking for a particular section, they can take you straight there. Picking up from where we left off at the end of part 4, we'd just exported the drum microphones as audio files from Superior Drummer 3. To bring the audio files into Luna, just open the folder where you've saved them, select the files, and then drag and drop them into the tracks window that's on the left-hand side. Luna will then automatically create the individual audio tracks inside the session. By default, these imported tracks will be routed to the main output. One other thing that you may find useful, to select all of the files in any Finder window, just use the shortcut Command-A. An alternative to this is just position the mouse underneath one of the files that you would like to select, left click and hold down with the mouse whilst you drag across the files. I now want to group together those three kick drum microphones and assign them to a bus. This way I can adjust them as just one instrument. A quick way of doing this is for me to select the first kick drum mic. I'm then going to hold down the shift key and click on the bottom kick drum mic. And now you can see I've automatically selected all three together. To create the kick drum bus, I'm going to use Command, Shift and B on the keyboard. As I do that, it will bring up a new window. You can then name the bus. So we're going to call this one Kick. And then add any extensions that you would like. So I'm going to add API Summing, the Master Tape and Vision channel strip, and then click create. Now, if we also go back and have a look at the three tracks that we've just imported, if we look at the output, you'll see they've automatically been assigned to the kick drum bus that we've just created. Okay, I'll just undo that example using Command and Z. There we go. So as you can see, I've actually grouped together the microphones for the kick, the snare, the hi-hat, the toms, the overheads, and also one bus for all the ambient mics. And then finally routed these buses together into one master drums bus. So you may be thinking, why not just use the stereo out from Superior Drummer and be done with it? And of course, you can do that, and there'll be nothing wrong in doing that at all. However, as I want the mix to sound as cohesive as possible, by printing the drum audio, I can then mix and process the drums using the same console, tape formula, and also place them inside the same ambient space as all the other instruments inside the song. If you've enjoyed this video so far, please take a quick second to hit that like button. It really helps out me and the channel more than you think. Now that I've got all the drum microphones routed to their respective buses, let's have a listen to the static drum mix, with and without the tape and summing extensions engaged. And conveniently, a new feature's just been added to Luna, with a bypass button located just below the audio meters. One other thing I'd like to mention here is I would tend to balance the drums overall using the drum buses first. If needed, I then adjust the individual volumes of any close microphones that feed into the same bus. A good example here would be the three tom mics where I've needed to set their relative volumes and their position from left to right. To find the correct position, I solo the stereo overheads first, and I then add in solo the close microphone, in this case the floor tom. Using the loop playback function, I can then go around that selected area. Then use the mute button to bring the microphone in and out to fine-tune its position. The UF8 control surface is fantastic for doing this. I quite often just find myself closing my eyes whilst making the adjustments so that I'm using my ears and not being distracted by the visual information on the screen. One other tip that I use all of the time is when I'm panning either a stereo instrument or bus, if you right-click on the pan control, it will reveal a drop-down menu. At the bottom of this drop-down menu is a simple stereo pan mode. By selecting this, it will then create one individual pan control. When scanning the mix later on, it's then very easy to see where you have panned the various instruments. If you double-click on the pan control, it will also show you a value for the pan, either left or right. As ever, it's been an absolute pleasure, guys. Thank you all so much for watching. If you've missed any of the earlier episodes and would like to check them out, I'll put links in the description below. Fridays, 4 p.m. BST is when we upload new content, so if you haven't already, please do like and subscribe to be notified of new videos from us in the future. It's always great to see your comments and any questions that you may have below. I always read everything that's posted, and I'll do my best to reply to everyone. I'm Matt from Distant Sun Studios, and I'll look forward to seeing you in the next one. Cheers.